Ken Patu. Good morning, Ken Patu. My morning fasting blood glucose is 105, but my midday is lower, 80s, and postprandial is well-controlled, 130 at peak. Returns to 80s within 2 hours. What does this imply? Ken, for our events, like we're having the boot camp event, we had a couple more people register for the boot camp event in Louisville past couple of days, by the way. And at any of these events, we'll start the mornings with morning blood sugar testing, you know, just finger stick testing. This time I'm bringing a couple of insulin buttons, Libre buttons, freestyle Libre buttons, which we'll hand out. We've done that a couple of times in the past. That's very popular as well. We will typically see 10 to 20% of attendees will have what's called the dawn effect. And that's what you're describing there, where you have a high blood sugar fasting, but it drops after eating. You know, most people think it's going to be low coming in, and then I'm going to eat something, eat breakfast, and it's going to go up. Again, with 10 to 20% of us, that's not what happens. We come in high, we eat something, and it goes low. Now, what causes that? It's called the dawn effect, D-A-W-N. Dawn is the time of day, dawn. And it's got to do with cortisol. We have what's called a diurnal or a circadian, just like everything else in our body in terms of metabolism, a circadian pattern for cortisol. Cortisol is like a long-acting version of epinephrine. It's made by the adrenal glands. It causes our blood sugar to go up. It like epinephrine, it's sort of fight or flight. It gets the human body ready for action. And about 3 to 7 o'clock each morning, almost all humans have an increase in our cortisol level. That is what leads to the higher fasting blood sugar. And then for those people who actually drop their blood sugar after they eat, what's going on there is they get an insulin response to their breakfast. And then that insulin response causes them to drop their blood sugar. Great question, Ken Patu. Thank you for raising it. Again, looks very much like classic dawn effect. Now, a lot of people get really concerned about when they have the dawn effect. I can tell you, I think there's maybe a little bit more more heat than light, more emotion than is probably warranted. Yes, you should pay attention when you have dawn effect. But here's the thing. When you're looking at burning your glycocalyx, you're looking at having blood sugars of 140 and above for hour after hour after hour each day. Most people that have dawn effect never get over, like you, Ken Patu. They get in the high 90s, 105, 110, something like that. And then usually after their first meal, it drops back down. So I don't really think you're getting a lot of damage to your glycocalyx and your arteries from a dawn effect. If somebody does know that, if you've seen any scientific evidence that you do, I'd be very interested to see it because I just don't.
There's nothing like a community. We saw that in the Louisville event. People got together and started talking about how they've had challenges and successes in preventing their own heart attack, stroke, or chronic disease. It became very clear that you don't have to be a doc with a full-time 30-year career in preventive medicine to understand this and successfully prevent heart attack, stroke, the number one killer and disablers of people. You don't have to be a physician to prevent eye disease, kidney disease. All you have to do is think, listen, and become part of the community. Now, how do you do that? Go to the membership login on our webpage, and as you can see, you can get right in. You have to sign up if you haven't signed up already. And I've already signed up. I've already gone in. It's very simple, very easy to understand. In order to help encourage this, after the success and the positive emotion, the positive impact that we're seeing with these events, we're saying, look, we need to offer more of these services for free in order to help grow this community. So You'll see us starting to do drawings for the webinar event, the courses. We've got a book coming out in about a month. We'll be offering that. Even full-blown evaluations, providing those for free for folks that, again, help us grow the community. So if you'd like to find out what the most recent rules are for the most recent drawing, just come to the membership page. Thank you for your interest.